We also had a late night last night. I will not talk about what they did last night, but there was no way we could wake up early this morning. So everyone, this is a Heartstrings Pictures Goes to Korea special. We are doing a review of convenience store food. What's the name of the convenience store that we went to?
Good to you.
Nice to meet you, Ole.
Happy to see you.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. So this is a Chinese style bowl rice.
According to the ingredients, there's pork, beef, chicken, and...
So let's try it.
Scallop, oyster.
Whoa. Honest opinion, if it sucks, just say it's bad.
It's bad. It's just sauce on rice, that's all.
I only taste some rice, sauce on some rice, that's all. That's it. Jay, how you feel?
Yeah, just sauce on some rice.
Okay, Daniel, the video is going well. That was an unsightly view.
Oh, Ming-Chin, sit up. So everything here we bought cost less than $5. Like each thing.
Oh, everything is less than $5.
No, okay. Total lah, but each is less than $5.
Okay. How is it? Is it worth it?
Yeah, rice on sauce. I think if you're hungry and you don't have money, it's not bad. Let's try, this is mushroom and chicken porridge, yeah. So let's open it up. All of this we have to microwave in the convenience store.
It tastes a bit bland. I don't know whether it is radio mix enough. Like this is a bit bland. But I think it is. I think it warms because it is in the winter now.
What is this?
Chicken. Try.
I don't think it's chicken at all.
Compared to the rice, which is better? Chin Hao.
This is good stuff if you are not feeling well.
Okay.
You want something bland and not too heavy on the seasoning. I think this is good stuff.
How is it, Daniel?
Can't stop.
I actually like it.
Yeah. It's quite healthy.
It's very tasty. Like, how do I put it? Like, it's not totally bland.
It's not too, like, it's not oily. It's
yeah, correct.
But you can't taste the chicken, right?
Yeah. I don't taste it.
Just like a normal actually, porridge.
No, man.
Or maybe the chicken is here.
Hmm.
We have to get the chicken bits.
Try, yeah. It tastes. It's not bad, not bad. I like it. Like,
I do like it also. That's what I say.
I actually like it.
This is something I'll definitely get. Not
too well. Yeah. Okay. Very good. Okay. Let's try. We have another porridge as well. But let's open it and take a look. This might be pumpkin porridge. This is chicken also.
Wait, let me try first.
Oh yeah, then you should try it before I try it.
Texture is different. Oh, okay. I can see the chicken.
Oh yeah. Let's try.
I taste like black bean and chicken. Is it black bean chicken?
Right.
Yeah, that's porridge. Black bean chicken.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this one you do feel a real chicken porridge, like. You have the chicken and you have the porridge in this porridge.
Yeah, this one you can taste the chicken a bit more.
I can smell a black bean from here actually.
This one has more flavor.
Actually, I do prefer this one for the overall texture.
I like this one.
Is it a texture?
Let me try it.
This one has more flavor.
But is this texture is better and the flavor?
I feel like it's not just that good. I feel
well
like
balanced.
Yeah. It works better together.
Yeah. I think to each his own.
Actually, this one. Oh, you prefer this one?
Jay, what do you?
Yeah, I think I prefer this one.
What about this one? You like?
Because this one is more flavorful compared to this, and I think it's more. I think to me, it's more fragrant.
Mm.
So this is the pumpkin porridge.
I'm most excited.
No,
about
this.
Pumpkin
it doesn't look like porridge. And what is this?
Pumpkin porridge. I think.
It's a ball.
It's a real pumpkin.
What
do you think?
There's a rice ball in it.
Oh, is it? Yeah. So is that a good or bad thing?
How about you try that as well?
It tastes funny, but... what is that a construction sound? Jane, can you show us where the construction is ongoing?
It tastes like... pumpkin soup, if you ask me. Yeah, Jimmy, what do you think?
I think it tastes a bit too artificial and sweet for me.
So it tastes like it's in between a dessert and a cream of pumpkin soup. Like it's quite sweet. It doesn't taste like porridge and but it's nice. Overall it's nice.
How about we all rank all these three porridge? Which one is your favorite, Daniel?
Very hard to compare the pumpkin with the other soup.
Because I feel like this is like pumpkin soup. This is not like porridge.
Yeah.
But if I compare these two porridge, like what you said, the chicken and bean one, it has more flavor. But this one has more balance.
Yeah, better texture.
Better texture. So like this is my favorite. Yeah. What about you?
She's the same for me. So for this one, you don't have any meat, but the flavor is there and it tastes healthy. And
yeah.
It tastes healthy yet flavorful enough.
Yeah. It's not bland. That's
yeah, it's not bland. This one tastes a little bit of a
herbs, flavor is okay.
Black bean, chicken. So, but
not as nice.
I don't like the texture.
For me, I think the chicken and black bean is the best.
Okay.
Why?
Yeah, you need
to
say why.
Why? Oh, because I think it's more flavorful compared to this one. And I think this tastes a bit artificial to me, so I didn't really like it.
So that's our review of the porridges. Let's go on to the snacks. If you guys know me, you guys know I don't eat snacks. But I'm doing this for you guys. So we have seasoned dried fish.
Okay.
And premium garlic jerky. So we found that unfortunately the premium garlic jerky contains beef. So King Wei will not be eating it. Well, that's interesting. That looks like
a biscuit.
Yeah. I'm interested.
That's dried fish, right? Let's try this.
Actually, this tastes like something we have in Singapore. You know, the fish.
Yeah, it is dry fish.
So it tastes normal, I guess.
It's something really crispy. Yeah. You can hear from this. It's really crispy and I think the flavor is there. I like it personally, but it's a little dry, but it's called dried fish, so.
Yeah.
I also think it's not bad.
I like it.
It's a slightly a bit sweet.
8 out of 10.
And spicy. Yeah.
8 out of 10.
Okay. I agree. So Daniel,
how about you? Okay.
Look at a crisp. I'm feeling the sound. Daniel, what do you think about it? Is it too spicy for the taste bud?
It is a bit. It is a bit spicy. Just a tiny bit.
The funny thing is, I didn't think about it until you mentioned it. It's like the spice took a while to kick in. And now it has kicked in. The flavor is stronger than I expected.
The fish flavor or the sweetness of it?
I don't think it's sweet. Is it sweet?
It's not sweet.
It's
sweetness. It's partial sweetness.
There's a fishy but yet sweetness and...
The spice for me overcome the sweetness. So when I first tried it before the spice kicked in, I thought it would be like, you know those like salty biscuit they eat. But now that the spice kicking in, I'm like, that's the only thing I can taste actually.
Out of 10. How would you rate it?
Compared to other snacks I've eaten.
This is the first
snack. Other Singapore or other Canadian snacks?
Quite dry.
It's quite dry, right?
Quite dry.
That's my concern.
So will you eat it again if you have a chance?
No, because spicy.
Oh.
But let's say excluding the spice flavor from it.
I feel like if it's no spice, the flavor not there.
Yeah.
Not there?
And it's too dry, I think. It's too dry.
Yeah. It's like, so seasoned dried fish, you know what I think of? I think a bit of but like...
cutterfish.
I expect the cutterfish.
Yeah.
Like the flavor.
Okay, come.
Okay, alright.
But I think the crunchiness is there. I think we can hear the crunchy sound of it. How about
this one is so dry?
Yeah, maybe.
Crunchy means dry.
Yeah, that's true.
Like crispy it? Means dry.
Yeah.
Jay, how about you? Do you like it?
I think it's okay for me. It's quite sweet and I guess it's relatively spicy.
Mm.
So I guess it's not bad.
What's your favorite Chinese New Year snack?
I guess for me it would be the bak kwa because I like meat. For me it would be the pineapple tart because that's the only thing I can think of. Although I don't really like it because it's really dry.
Okay.
A little dry on the outside but it's sweet in the inside. So.
Mm. Just like you.
No, I'm sweet on the inside.
Actually,
yeah, just like me. Just like me.
Okay. I'll be real. My favorite Chinese New Year snack. We call it love letter.
Okay.
So it's like egg rolls, basically, for my Canadian audiences. The reason I ask is because this snack reminds me of like a Chinese New Year snack.
Which one?
The seasoned dried fish.
Which Chinese New Year snack?
No, it feels like something that you eat during Chinese New Year. You know,
actually, yes.
We have something similar to this. Actually.
Yeah.
So if we let's say this is a Chinese New Year snack, would you think this is a good Chinese New Year snack?
Overall, still yes for me. But you just have to get ready a lot of beverages.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's a good Chinese New Year snack, actually.
So this is the beef jerky. Or it's not beef jerky. It contains, I think, pork, beef and chicken, is it?
Yeah, I think so. So it says garlic jerky. I guess that makes sense because they don't call it beef jerky.
Yeah, so it's...
Because it's like all
It's three. A combination of all the different meats together with garlic.
We call it the meat lover's jerky.
It tastes like the Chinese New Year bak kwa, but...
Pork jerky.
Pork jerky, but... the garlic taste is extremely high. So I taste garlic more than I taste any of the meat. So it's like a garlic jerky to me. I personally do not like it.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's a bit like...
The texture is of a pork jerky.
When you eat jerky, what do you expect? You expect like, well, obviously you expect saltiness. And then you expect like the meat flavor.
But this is one, there a sweetness to it?
The first thing you taste is garlic.
Oh, so there's no...
And the last thing you taste is still garlic.
Yeah. So like, instead of the saltiness, you get like a garlic flavor.
Yeah, very strong garlic. Jake, you should try it.
I can't eat it, sorry.
Nobody can see you.
So how does it compare to all the jerky I've eaten in Canada? Or do you even eat...
So yes, candy? I have a friend in church.
His name is
dad.
Jose.
No. I have a friend's dad in church who actually makes jerky. Shout out to Mr. Tam. His jerky, I tried before. It's actually pretty good. But the only one I tried was a free sample. I'm sorry, Hope. I know you always try to sell jerky to me, but I cannot take spicy food. And I'm also very cheap. I will not pay $10 for a bag of jerkies. Good job! Okay, my turn. Wow. 2 out of 2.
Well done.
Okay, now let's go to the drinks. So, based on the convenience store food you've tried so far, what do you think of like basic convenience store food in Korea?
I think it's not bad. I quite like the porridge and then the black bean and chicken. So I guess it's filling, and it's, especially now in the cold weather, it should be able to warm me up quite well. Yeah.
But how you compare to like Singapore convenience store food?
Singapore, I don't usually eat convenience food store because I think there's food really available everywhere. So okay, I just eat food court food or something.
Yeah, compared to Canada for your viewers.
It's interesting because people don't go to convenience store in Canada for food. They either go for washroom, because when you drive long distance, right, the first thing you think of is like gas station convenience store to go to washroom. Second thing is coffee, because again, when you drive long distance, yeah, coffee. So the coffee and washroom, and then maybe you like grab a snack, like literally to eat on the way and everything. You don't have like cup noodles, maybe you have like bread, you don't have like rice.
I think it's quite similar to Singapore, except for the flavor, like what we tried. Like in Singapore, I don't see a lot of like porridges, like this pumpkin porridge. Yeah. But what I see is like maybe we have things like butter chicken. It's an Indian style cuisine. It's more very popular 7-Eleven specialty microwave food. So that is nice also, but both are nice, but it's just that the flavor are totally different that cater to the local flavor.
Do you think the variety here is better than in Singapore?
I wouldn't say better. I would say there are more choice here. There are more choice here, but over there, there's lesser choice, but it is catered to the local taste bud in Singapore. Okay. Yeah.
But see, you can say the same for Korea. Like,
yeah, so this is catered for the Korean taste bud. But for tourists like us, like personally, I do appreciate both sides.
Yeah.
But I think a question for them is, do you prefer this if it's in Canada? Like when you have the long drive, then you're able to get all this conveniently instead of going to like restaurants or that where you have to
It's definitely cheaper lah, that's the thing. Restaurant is like, you won't go to a restaurant on a long road trip because you don't want to wait. Like you just want to get the food and go. Sometimes that's why people go for fast food. Will I pick this over restaurant food? Not really, because if I'm going to a restaurant, the expectation is like, you know, I go on a date.
How about compared to fast food?
Yeah, good. Compared to fast food, yes. So next, we're trying the drinks. Actually, I think I'm most excited about the drinks because like food and everything, you don't go to a convenience store to get food. Like you go to like restaurant or like fast food outlet or something to get food. But drinks, yeah, you can go to a convenience store to get. That's why I'm like...
In Canada?
Yeah, in Canada. Okay. You can also go to supermarket lah, but supermarket not as convenient as convenience store.
This one I think is banana milk.
It is banana milk.
Next, this is grape. Gentle grape. Because some grapes are rough. Jeju milk. This is interesting because I don't know what Jeju milk is. Are there cows on Jeju? Probably, right?
Yes.
Other than a cow, this guy is his favorite food.
This one, I'm also interested.
It looks like banana milk.
Corn.
Oh, corn milk.
So, yeah, I'm like, is it corn milk or like, well, what is it? That's not interesting. So, that's why drinks I'm like most interested in trying. So, this is the vegan banana milk. Chinwei, don't laugh and drop, okay?
Don't make false information.
Chinwei has a... dropped the camera quite a few times already.
Yeah. Got a low sense of humor today.
Trunk.
Actually, it's a high sense of humor. Because usually you have no sense of humor.
That's what I want to say.
I do not like banana.
You don't like banana?
I don't like banana.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
You know my favorite drink is actually banana milk.
Oh. Shake.
Yeah, banana milk.
Actually, I can taste. I don't know if that banana taste. But I think it's not bad.
So I'll tell you what my expectation is and why I like banana milk. Because in Singapore, we have two brands of banana milk, which I really like. HL and Dutch Lady.
Oh, I've drank Dutch Lady before. I think it tastes like Dutch Lady. Okay,
Canada got one brand, Milk to Go, which is quite common.
So is that milk?
It is milk. Mm. And they have banana milk. But I try, it's all like... I don't say it's all the same, but you know, I like it.
I think you would like this. It tastes like the Dutch Lady banana milk, I think. But it has more, a bit more milk banana flavour.
She really like it. This guy really like it. It's more than 50% gone in one single shot.
Wait, it's your turn to try it.
Wait.
Okay.
I like it, but it tastes a little artificial. Too sweet. It's too sweet. Like, you know banana milkshake?
It's not supposed to be so sweet. Because banana is not sweet.
If you drink banana milkshake, you taste the banana, a bit of milk and sometimes some sugar or whatever they add in, some syrup.
Yeah.
But you still taste the banana. But this one tastes artificially sweet. But it's nice, but it doesn't taste like banana milkshake.
But it's similar to the Singapore one.
Yeah, it tastes like the ones like HL and Dutch.
Because genuine banana milk is not that sweet. I would say it's not sweet at all.
Okay.
What's the next one you should get?
Corn.
Corn milk?
Actually, I don't know what this is. This just say corn.
It is corn drink. Yeah. I don't know, is it milk? Let's try it.
Okay.
This is going to be interesting.
Let me have it first.
Yeah.
Because Daniel might have finished the whole thing at once.
It looks like banana milk.
Yeah, it looks like banana milk.
It reminds me of Meiji.
Actually, no.
The Meiji bottle. It has a handle.
No, this looks more like an oil bottle.
Oh, nice.
Cooking oil.
Yeah.
So you know in Singapore there's a night market, they sell this corn drink.
They sell corn drink in night market?
Yeah, in the night market there's this, they sell drinks like bandung, sometimes melon drink.
Which is rose syrup.
Rose syrup, yeah. Bandung is rose syrup.
Yeah.
And then sometimes they sell this corn drink also. So this
is
exactly like the one in the Singapore pasar.
Let me tell you my expectation. When I think of corn drink, the thing I can think of is you know like corn soup, chicken corn soup, the Chinese kind. Well, obviously, I don't think
it's... How about Western? There's a cream of corn as well.
It's similar.
I think it would taste something like cream of corn,
but
it's sweet.
Sweeter.
Yeah, much sweeter, yeah.
A lot of syrup.
Okay. Yeah, you can try it then.
So that's my expectation. Yeah. Wow, the corn taste is actually quite strong.
Yeah.
Actually, you're right. It tastes like the cream of corn soup.
But it's much sweeter.
Much sweeter, yeah.
Are you pleasantly surprised by it?
Yeah, because I had no expectations.
There's actually a ice cream brand in Singapore, Marigold. So they have a subsidiary brand called Potong. So you heard of that, right?
So it's an ice cream now.
Yeah, it's an ice cream brand with a steak and just some flavor.
Yeah.
So I think the popular brand are red bean, durian, and sweet corn. So even jackfruit. So so this drink actually tastes exactly like the sweet corn flavor.
Do you think that it's actually a good drink, or do you think it's just the thing that you won't try again?
This is something I would try again. This drink tastes unique. It's not something I want to drink every day, but you know, once a while, I do feel like having this drink. It's just unique. Like you don't get to taste this everywhere.
How about you, Daniel?
I like the banana drink more.
I can tell you have been drinking that. No, it's that the banana milk is totally empty already.
Okay, so this is the Jeju milk. None of us here have tried this before. So Daniel will be the first to give us his opinion on this Jeju milk.
This is how this guy deals with dangerous situations.
Yeah,
pass it on to someone else. Yeah. He's like, wow, that waterfall looks dangerous. I think it'll be fun to jump down. Daniel
first.
Can you pack this thing?
Can I?
Then you try it.
Cool.
Let the daredevil do it.
Pet a meal one.
Let it spill again. So this Jeju milk, right? Actually tastes like HL milk. Is it okay?
So what I think, this is normal milk. Yeah, it's just this. No, it's less flavorful than what we have in Singapore, actually, I think.
For me, I feel that it tastes a little bit like the HL milk, but it's a little sweet, but
It's sweet.
It's not that sweet, actually.
It's quite bland, actually.
It's bland?
It's quite bland.
I feel like it's like...
Or maybe I don't drink milk enough.
Like 1% milk. Oh, like skim milk.
Yeah.
1% fat.
Yeah. Like it tastes like that.
I think so.
As in, all those different packet meals that I drink is much more flavorful.
Oh, well, that one definitely, yeah. That one is like a lot of sugar. But like, this one is like, so you know, like 0%. Don't drink already. Oh, don't drink.
It's in your, on your neck.
It tastes like HL milk.
No, HL milk is sweeter.
Yeah, HL milk is sweeter. No, it's more flavorful. No, no, it's not sweet.
It's not that sweet. No, no, no. Maybe it's a corn that's still in my mouth.
This is the, maybe because we tried the banana. I tried the banana milk. That's why this is. So this really reminds me of like 1% milk. Okay. So last thing, this is not milk.
Stop it, Daniel. Stop it.
This is grape.
Grape juice.
It's called gentle grapes.
You know one thing I don't like about fruit juice in like convenience store and supermarket.
Let me guess.
It's too sweet.
There's too much.
Correct. Yeah. Too sweet. Too sugary.
Let you try.
I know what it tastes like. I think I know what it tastes like.
Okay, I know.
I
think I know, so.
I don't know what it tastes like. I think I know it. Wait. So you feel must.
So it's 3, 2, 1, then say.
Okay.
3, 2, 1. Cool. Dash jelly.
Cool. Dash jelly. Okay, it's a texture of dash jelly, but you know cool.
Cool.
Q-O-O. Yeah. This is
like aloe vera, right?
Kind of. Aloe vera. This is a jelly.
Grass jelly.
Yeah. Q-O-O. Yeah. So this drink Q-O-O, there's a great flavor and it tastes like it with aloe vera.
It's quite flavorful, but I think it's too sweet.
What does it remind you of?
It's like a kid's drink.
Yeah, it's like sugar, very concentrated like syrup. Then you put it for like events. Then they will just dilute it down with water. But I didn't expect it to be jelly.
Do you think it's sweet? Like, do you think it's very sweet?
I think it's very sweet. I think it's a good drink to have if you want a quick energy rush.
You want to get sugar rush, you can drink that. Then after that, it's a sugar crash.
So, one thing that our viewers may not see is that this is actually jelly. Like, it's not just one liquid, that's the thing. Like, there's some stuff inside.
Okay, so those are our drinks. What is your favorite out of this four?
I think the thing that stood out is really the corn.
Oh, actually, yeah. The corn milk. Out.
But I don't know whether it's a good or bad way, but I don't mind trying it again.
For me, I would say if something that I would drink on a regular day would be the banana milk.
You guys know what my favorite is, so.
Yeah, let's move on to our last segment, ice cream. We always save room for dessert.
But we only have one dessert.
Yeah, it's fine. We're friends.
HBAF, what's that?
Honey, butter, almond. I can't remember the... Because this brand is famous for its honey butter almond snack.
It's okay.
Ooh. Wow, ooh. Nice.
Ooh.
What is this? Okay.
Take a look. Oh. No, the top is inside.
The top is in here.
Oh no, we left the top.
Forget it.
No, no, we can't forget it. Okay, we'll just eat this. Just eat this, yeah.
You can take it from here.
Oh, I guess he was supposed to.
Okay.
It's like a...
So imagine just now that corn drink.
But as ice cream.
Sweeter.
Uh-huh.
Added caramel. Then you try it and tell me, is it something like that?
Well, firstly, this is a little soggy, but I'm not particular. Hey, Chimmy. Ooh.
The almond is here.
Oh, that's the almond. Okay. Okay. No, then let's try the flavor of the ice cream before you judge the top.
Yeah, it's nice. It's like
try the ice cream here.
It's not supposed to look like it. You just have to let it melt.
Nice. I don't know how to describe it.
Is it sweet?
I don't know if I would say it's like corn milk. It's sweet lah, but...
Doesn't it taste like the corn with the caramel? I think it's not corn, but...
It's butter.
Honey butter.
I guess so.
Hard to describe it other than honey butter almond. But if you say caramel, If you tell me this, it tastes like caramel flavor, I would say yeah. Can I try this?
Let's see. Let me try. There's nothing left. There's nothing left. Hey, tell me to try.
It's not dripping.
This marks the end of our...
Oh wait, before we end, which one is your favorite of all the things we tried?
Okay, what's your guess?
Banana milk.
You know what? I think this is my favorite.
Okay, well, how about you, Jimmy? What's your favorite?
I think the ice cream is my favorite too.
Yeah.
Jina, what about you?
Oh, you guys should try. You didn't reach the bottom of the ice cream.
Special stuff.
Yeah. Special. It's basically chocolate.
Oh, just like those.
Yeah.
I do like this. I choose it.
Favorite, right?
I wish to try it with this.
Frozen. So what? Okay, excluding the ice cream, what is the best?
Excluding banana milk.
Pumpkin porridge.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh. Dessert plus
milk. Pumpkin porridge.
Yeah, actually. Dessert for you, Jimmy.
I'm getting it's a baked bean porridge.
Baked bean porridge. Okay.
But I think with all the consensus is the ice cream is the best.
Yeah, we're biased. We all have sweet teeth. So can you say something to end off this video?
I don't know if we'll be doing another review. If you like what we did today, comment down below. And maybe we can try something different next time. By next time, I mean like it will be virtual. Because this guy will be back in Singapore. And I will be back in Canada. I think my favorite part of tonight was watching him spill the milk. Okay, that's all for now. Goodbye. Good night.
Subscribe to.
Okay. No. I believe in you doing it organically. If my content is good, if my believers, if my subscribers are believers,
like my share viewers and are subscribe.
If my viewers are believers, they will do it even though I don't tell them to. I don't like unwilling followers. Complain. Okay, let's try. Okay.
This is Heartstrings Pictures goes to Korea. The crash landing on you special.